found something. I've spotted something.
The doors loom above you, one step closer to the Council, one step closer to divinity. The others must surely be thinking the same. After all, only one of you can ultimately ascend. Time for an honest discussion, perhaps.
Thanks, Senya. Did he send ya? As ready, God King. They came out of nowhere and killed us all. As ready. Rise me up. Rise me. I serve the God King. Rise me up. Rise me up, God King. This ain't right. This ain't how it's supposed to be. This ain't the promise.
I must speak with this man. Please stay close and keep an eye out for assassins in the shadows. Very good. Now for some answers.
Red Prince, at last we meet, or rather, meet with your awareness of my presence. How often I've stood by you, but an arm's length away, a shadow within the shadows. Untouchable. Almost like meeting an old friend.
His eyes are black holes in a black-skinned sky. He bows with the deference of a noble among nobles, swinging ever so playfully between sincerity and sarcasm.
I suppose I should start with an apology for the attempts on your life. Talk about getting off on the wrong foot, wouldn't you say?
Failed attempts, remember? Hardly made me break a sweat, those lackeys of yours.
To my astonishment, and I admit my admiration. You may find this hard to believe, but given different circumstances, I would have been quite content to let you live. Let you play the Emperor from your golden throne in your golden city. Alas, certain events beyond even my control were set in motion. Ripples became waves. I had to act. And so I arranged for you to meet with an unfortunate self-inflicted end. His libido is legendary. How could he resist? And what better way to organize his demise? But of course I didn't know then he was God-woken, stronger than the demon. It's almost a pity we find ourselves on such opposite sides. All because of who you are, and all because of who she is. It was Sadha who set events in motion, Red Prince. If you were the ripple, she was the wave. She's a tidal wave that will take wing, become a murder of dragons, red as the setting sun, that will alight every corner of this world with the terrible splendor of fire.
And I, their proud father.
But don't you see, you who wants to be emperor, that you're enacting the downfall of our race? The simple truth of the matter is that, yes, we lizards were dragons once. The mightiest creatures to rule sky, earth, and sea. But such was the jealousy of our power that all other races united against us and brought us to the brink of extinction. No one knows what happened next. Was it wizardry? Was it Zol Stissa who took mercy on us even then? Suddenly we were dragons no more. Lizards instead. And as lizards we flourished and built an empire once more. But the House of Dreams trades in prophecy. They've always known we could be dragons again. For one day a man and a woman will be born, and their skin will be red, and the fruit of their union will be great red dragons.
A day that will come to pass.
Curse your obstinance. Listen to me. I am the House of Shadows. This is my role. I see the great games in motion, allow them their flux when they advance for good, cut them short when they advance for evil, even if that means doing evil. The renaissance of dragons would spell the end of our race, plain and simple. To that end, I needed you to die, but you proved to be all too worthy an opponent. An opponent, I would now see an ally. Ally with me, Red Prince. Find Sadha and kill her. If she births dragons, all other races will unite against us, and this time they will destroy us for good. We were spared last time. The condition of our continued existence was that we'd never let the dragon roar again.
They look each other in the eyes, like two chess players contemplating their next move.
Actually, I think I'll call his bluff.
Now then, I'm the Red Prince. Your role in this story is over. I am its sole protagonist. Sadha may indeed be dangerous. I may decide she must die. I may not. But it will be my decision. You're out of options, Master of Shadows. Tell me where she is.
The Shadow Prince stands checkmated, and he knows it.
I truly have no choice, have I? Very well. I must put the fate of all lizards in your hands. But beware. Sadha is ultimately dangerous. Not only will she be the mother of dragons, I fear she's fallen in with an old enemy. Them.
He points to the fallen black ring.
If I'm correct, and Sadha's heart has been darkened by the ring, you may be able to find her through their scrying magic. There's a thing on this island known as the Sallow Man. He is a master of mirrors. Mirrors like his will read your mind and show you what you desire, if you manage to elude or eliminate him. A word of warning, though. He is like a shred of nightmare ripped from the dream realm, set loose in reality. Do not underestimate this creature. Be careful, and become the savior of all lizards, Red Prince. Become the true emperor of your people.
I will be emperor, yes. Of lizards or dragons, that remains to be seen. Go ahead.
The prince narrows his eyes at you, each one glittering in the light.
So the House of Shadows thinks Sadha a threat. Their shadow prince wants me to kill her because she will be the mother of dragons. Fire, destruction, the end of the world. What do you think? My thoughts exactly.
How resolved he looks. How royal his bearing.
Or did you think I'd be swayed by that shadow mongrel? His kind, it is all cowardice. They who are scared of what might happen do well to be afraid of what will happen, for they only strengthen the resolve of those they oppose. As for the world's reaction, I will deduce, I will instruct. And so it does not matter how the world reacts. Each eventuality ends with my victory. Surely it's obvious. Ascension awaits.
Something in the distance, a strange tune. Sibyl freezes. It's her scar song. The master is near.
He's close. We must turn back now, or he'll have me under his thrall once more. I need to find someone I can trust enough to share the scar song with. It's the only way.
Please, go ahead. I think you know the answer to that. First, I'll find the master. He has a date with a needle. Whatever comes after that, comes after that.
My word, a godwoken. I'm almost honored. There are precious few things in this world that elude me, but divinity is very much one of them. Very much so. Never knew what hit them. They never do. I am a man with no name. They call me the Shadow Prince. But that is rather dramatic, and in fact, rather incorrect. For what I truly am is the House of Shadows itself. That is my role and my purpose. I see the great games in motion, allow them their flux when they advance for good, cut them short when they advance for evil. Even if that means doing evil. As such, I am here to cut short a very ancient evil indeed, and would welcome the aid of one as formidable as your divine self. You're too kind. One would prefer a more idyllic setting than this, but let me regale you with a story. Once upon a time, the race of lizards was so much more than what we are now. We were dragons once. Great red dragons. No one remembers this, but the elves are our guilt. As dragons, we almost wiped them from the face of the earth. We were stopped, and we were punished. I know not how. But someone took away the fire that made us dragons. Wings clipped, we became lizards. But there was a reason our dragon ancestors wanted to destroy the elves, for they too had a plot for world domination at the expense of all other races. And while we were punished, the remaining elves were spared. The elven scions are the key. After their deaths, the powers and souls of scions linger on in the vast and ever-growing network that connects all of the ancestor trees. We discovered that once the network will be large enough, dryads will sprout from these roots, equipped with the memories, experience, and enormous powers of generations of elves. A vast, invincible army that will obliterate everything in their path. It will be the end of all other races. I've been trying to stop them for years. Now I'm close to ending it all for good. Will you help me? I said that what eluded me is divinity, not the power to kill divinity.
He whistles for his assassins.
Shadow to shadow.
master's dead. Finally, I am free.
must fall.
The Elven Tree must fall. The Elven Tree must fall. He fears it. He fears the elves. The Elven Tree must fall. The Elven Tree must fall. He fears it. He fears the elves.
Do not do this. Do not do this.
Yes. Now that the Master's dead, might as well pursue divinity, I say.
The air is thick with heavy flakes of ash. The altar before you seems to radiate heat as you approach. An emblem of the sun glows faintly on the altar, but all you can hear is the hiss and rumble of the volcano and your own heavy breath. The air is thick with heavy... An emblem of the sun glows faintly on the altar, but all you can hear is the hiss and rumble of the volcano and your own heavy breath.
You there! Prithee, goodly traveler, might I prevail upon you to answer a question? You see, I am on a mission most grave. I seek a sorcerer most foul, most reviled, most feared. Her name is...
His pincers scissor wildly.
Scepter, the ineffable! Have you heard tell of this wicked beast on your travels? Oh, oh no. You spoke to her. Face to... whatever you call the odd frontly part of your person. I regret to inform you, you haven't much longer to live then. Now that she has your scent, it won't be long until Scepter tracks you here and guts you like a minnow. You have my sympathy. The hunt continues. Imperio, away!
The air is thick with heavy flakes of ash. The altar before you seems to radiate. The air is thick with an emblem of the sun glows faintly on the altar, but all you can hear is the hiss and rumble of the volcano and your own heavy breath. The air is thick with heavy an emblem of the sun glows faintly.